top tech leaders come to Davos. Wednesday was something of a tech day at the World Economic Forum in Davos. The 2,500 business, government and academic leaders attending the conference got to hear from a string of top tech execs, including Facebook COO Sheryl Sandberg, who spoke about the importance of internet access for all.
Connectivity, data access is too important to keep it only to the world's rich. There are 4 billion people in the world who don't have access. And when they get access, they are more highly educated, they have job opportunities, they have longer, healthier, more productive lives.
Facebook is researching just this. Its Aquila drone is solar-powered and could beam down a 10 gigabit connection to hard-to-connect places. Connectivity was also in the mind of GM CEO Mary Barra. Cars have rapidly moved from mechanical to highly complex electronic devices, and that's not stopping. Autonomous driving technology of the future could make our roads much safer and driving more fuel efficient.
We are at the start of an industrial revolution, and in the auto industry, it's really being driven by the convergence of connectivity, electrification, and changing customer needs. The convergence is allowing automakers like GM to develop dramatically cleaner, safer, smarter, and more energy-efficient vehicles for customers around the world.
Indeed, the so-called fourth industrial revolution was the theme for the day. But who's going to benefit from this?
There is going to be economic surplus that's going to be created because of this fourth industrial revolution. The question is, how evenly will it be spread between countries, between people in different economic strata, and also different parts of the economy?
UBS released a report this week that said the rich stand to gain from advances in robotics, while the poor will be worse off because they could lose jobs to machines. But the overall outlook isn't great for companies in 2016. A PwC study paints an overall pessimistic outlook.
Whether it's the volatile Chinese markets, the rising political tensions around the world, the disruptive technologies that we're all aware of, CEOs see real challenges ahead, and this is reflected in how they view the prospect for the global economy.
And on ISIS, Facebook's Sandberg talked about a role for the internet.
The best thing to speak against recruitment by ISIS are the voices of people who were recruited by ISIS, understand what the true experience is, have escaped and come back to tell the truth.
The US government recently asked tech companies to help them battle online radicalization. One of their ideas is giving greater exposure to credible voices that can talk to youth. So Sandberg's comments are interesting. Obama's government could have an ally in her and Facebook.